In this exciting After Effects tutorial, you'll learn how to create 4 super useful transitions using just 2 effects on 1 layer. I'll take you through the step-by-step process of creating these transitions and saving them as animation presets with this comprehensive tutorial. Support my channel by buying my brand new text animator template, buy a shirt or mug from my online store, sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, or donate if you're feeling generous and get something out of my tutorials. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Links for everything, including the project file, are in the description below. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so with our playhead in between these two clips where they meet right here in the center, press Command-Shift-Y to create an adjustment layer. And this is going to be the layer where we add all of our effects, and we'll be able to save this as an animation preset so you can bring this into any project. Okay, so before we get too deep into this, I did want to mention a few shortcuts that we'll be using quite a bit in this tutorial, and I encourage you to learn these because this will make your life a lot easier. If you press the left bracket, it will bring your endpoint to where your playhead is. If you Alt left bracket, it will trim the layer to where your playhead is. And if you press your right bracket, it will bring your out point to where your playhead is. And Alt right bracket will trim your layer to where your playhead is. So first, let's shift page up to go back 10 frames. And then Alt left bracket to trim our adjustment layer to where our playhead is. And then we're going to shift page down twice to move forward 20 frames. And Alt right bracket. So that way, our adjustment layer is 20 frames in length. Okay, so let's go over to our effects and presets and add in our effects for this transition. So start to type offset, then just double click to add that. And then we also need to grab a fast box blur. So double click and we'll add it there. So let's go back to the beginning of our layer and let's take a look at offset. Put a keyframe at the very beginning at 960/540. And then I'm also going to go ahead and put in a keyframe on fast box blur with our blur radius set to 0. Press U to reveal those keyframes. If you press O, it will jump to the out point of this layer. So first, we're going to create a horizontal transition. So we need to shift our center point by 1920 pixels, either right or left, because this comp is a 1920 by 1080 comp. So if 960 is our center point, we need to move it by 1920 pixels. So to move this to the left by 1920, just put 960 minus 1920, and this will shift our center to the left. Okay, and then for our fast box blur, let's go ahead and put a keyframe set at 0 at the out point. If we go to where those two clips meet, and for our fast box blur, let's change that to 100 pixels. And if we open this up, let's change our blur dimension to horizontal. Likewise, whenever we're doing a vertical transition, we would set this to vertical. If we scrub through here, we can see how that kind of hides that cut a little bit better. But we need to make some more changes. So let's select all of these keyframes and F9 to make those easy ease. Let's take a look at our offset keyframes. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of zoom in here so you can see this a little bit better. The main thing for the offset keyframes is that you want your influence to be about the same on the in and out. As I kind of move this forward, you can see how our influence is climbing, and that's about 70, maybe 80%. You can use any percentage you want, but the main thing to take away is that whatever percentage you use for the incoming influence, you want to match that pretty close to the outgoing. I recommend at least 70%, but you can go all the way up to 100% if you'd like. Pull this right keyframe over, and again, we're going to go to about 80%. Doesn't have to be exact, but pretty close. If you jump a little bit before this transition and hit B, it will bring your work area handle over, and go a little bit past it, and then press N, it will bring the other handle over. So that's a good shortcut to remember, B and N. That controls your work area handles. Okay, so let's just watch this play back. And there's your horizontal transition going to the left. So with just a few minor tweaks, we can actually get 4 different transitions out of this one effect. The thing that we'll be changing is this second keyframe on our offset, and we'll change the blur dimension to either horizontal or vertical, depending on whether it's a horizontal or vertical transition. But the main thing to remember is to change the value of this second offset keyframe. If we want to go in the opposite direction, let's change this last keyframe back to 960, but this time let's add 1920, and that's going to give us 2880. So as you can see, just by changing that value, we can go in the opposite direction. So just one change and you have a totally different transition. So now let's do a vertical transition. We're going to set our offset back to 960/540 on that last keyframe. Change our blur dimensions on our fast box blur to vertical. So now on this last keyframe, we're going to add 1080 to our Y value. Because again, this is a 1920 by 1080 comp. So we need to increase this value by 1080. Watch that play back. And now we have a transition that goes down. And then for the final transition, let's change this back to 540, but this time subtract 1080, and this will transition our footage up. Okay, and let's save this as an animation preset. Make sure that you have effects selected and go up to animation, save animation preset. And this is going to go into your documents, Adobe, the version you're using. I'm in 2023, user presets. Now I have a folder called 7-Minute AE. You can either create your own folder or just drop this anywhere inside of your user presets. And I'm going to call this transition slide. Select save. Now I want to get rid of this adjustment layer because I always like to check to make sure that my animation presets actually work the way that I want them to. Go over to our effects and presets, go down to user presets, and in my 7-Minute AE folder, there we can find slide. So now it's really important to keep in mind where your playhead is because we have keyframes. Whenever you drop in an animation preset, if it has keyframes, it will drop the first keyframe wherever your playhead is. We have ours in the right place. It's 10 frames before our cut. So I'm just going to double click that. If you press U, you can see that we have our keyframes. Now notice that the preset came in on a solid. If you don't have any layer selected, it's going to add it to a solid. Now you can either bring in an adjustment layer then add this to it, or you can leave it on a solid, and we'll go over in just a second how you can make a solid an adjustment layer. But first, let's go ahead and trim up this layer to the keyframes, which is something that I always like to do. So if we go to this first set of keyframes and select Alt left bracket, it will trim our layer to this first set of keyframes. Let's go to these last set of keyframes, put our playhead right there, and then Alt right bracket, and that will trim our out point to where our playhead is. And like I mentioned, this effect was brought in on a solid. So as of right now, you can't really use this, but if you select this button right here, it will turn your solid into an adjustment layer. And there you go. That's how you can get 4 transitions using an adjustment layer and a couple of effects. Now that you've saved this as an animation preset, you can add it to a collection and bring it into any project with just a click of a button. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.